Let's have a look at part B. Consider the completed truth table for the given logic statement. There are four errors in the truth table in the output X column. Identify the four incorrect outputs. Write the row number to identify each incorrect output. The way we're going to identify these outputs is by completing the entire truth table and then comparing the last two columns. All right, to complete the truth table, we're going to have a look at the gates in our logic circuit. I've brought this logic circuit over from part A, and we're going to assign each logic gate a column in our truth table. The way we're going to complete this is in alphabetical order of our gates. So you can see we've labeled these gates from left to right, M, N, P, Q, R, and S. Starting off with M, M is an AND gate. So we're going to write M in our first column. The inputs for the AND gate is on the left-hand side. So following these lines back, we have A and we have B as our first two inputs. Let's go ahead and highlight these. The reason we want to highlight these is so that we can keep track of which columns are being used. The rule for the AND gate is that both inputs need to be true for the output to be true. And we're going to write the output under the M column. So going row by row, we're going to apply the AND condition to each column. Starting off with A as 0 and B as 0, this does not satisfy our AND gate condition, so we're going to write 0 in the output column. The same thing for row 2, we have both A as 0 and B as 0, so we're going to write 0 in the output column. The third row, we have 0 and 1, again, that doesn't satisfy the AND condition, so we're going to write 0, the same thing for the fourth row, 0 and 1. The fifth row, we have 1 and 0, which does not satisfy the condition, so we're going to write 0. Sixth row is the same. In the seventh row, both A and B are 1, or true, which does satisfy our AND condition, meaning the output is going to be true. And the same thing for the eighth row. The next logic gate we'll look at is going to be N, in alphabetical order. This is our NOT gate. The input for the NOT gate, following from the left, is going to be B. So let's go ahead and write N in the next column. The rule for the NOT gate is that it inverts the input. So whenever we have a 0, we're going to write a 1. And whenever we have a 1, we're going to write a 0. Again, going row by row, with the first row, we have a 0. So we write a 1 in our output column. Second row is the same. We have a 0, so we write a 1. Third row, we have a 1. So we're going to write a 0. The same for the fourth row. And this just repeats 0, 1. 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 0. All right, the next gate we're going to look at is going to be P. P is an AND gate. The two inputs now are N and C. Let's go ahead and highlight those. All right, let's go ahead and write P in our next column. And the condition again for the AND gate is that both columns need to be true for the output to be true. Starting off with row number 1, we have C as 0 and N as 1. So our output is going to be a 0. Row 2, we have C as 1 and N as 1. That does satisfy the AND condition, so we're going to write a 1. Row 3, we have 0 and 0, so we're going to write a 0. Just notice how I'm skipping over the M column. M is not being used in this case. Row 4, we have 1 and 0, so I'm going to write a 0. That doesn't satisfy our condition. Row 6, we have 1 and 1, which does satisfy the condition. Row 7 does not satisfy the AND condition, and row 8 does not satisfy our condition. Continuing alphabetically, we have Q as our next gate. Q is an OR gate with the inputs of M and P. Let's write those down. The condition for the OR gate is that either column can be true for the output to be true. So starting off with our first row, we have 0 and 0. That's going to give us a 0 by the OR condition. The second row, we have M as 0 and P as 1. That does satisfy our OR condition, so we're going to write a 1. 3 is the same as our first row, so we have a 0. And 4 is also the same. 5 is also the same. And 6, we have 0 and 1, which does satisfy the OR condition. 7th row, we have M as 1, P as 0, which does satisfy the OR condition, and the same for row number 8. The next logic gate we'll look at is going to be R. R is a NOT gate with the input as C. Let's go ahead and write that down. As before, the condition for the NOT gate is that it inverts the input. So whenever we have a 0, we're going to write down a 1, and whenever we have a 1, we're going to write down a 0. Let's go through row by row. Starting off with our first row, you can see we're skipping over 4 completed columns now. The first row, we have a 0, so R is going to be 1. Second row, we have a 1, so we're going to write down a 0. And you can see this pattern just repeats 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. So we can write the inverse of that, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. The last gate we'll look at is going to be S, which is an XOR gate. The two inputs for the XOR gate are Q and R. The condition for the XOR gate is that only one of the inputs can be true for the output to be true. That is why it's called XOR, in other words, exclusive OR, meaning exclusively one of the inputs can be true. So going through row by row, Q is 0 and R is 1. That does satisfy our condition, so we're going to write a 1. Row 2, we have Q is 1 and R is 0, so we're going to write a 1. Row 3, it does satisfy the condition, we have a 0 and a 1. Row 4, we have 0 and 0, which doesn't satisfy our condition, right? Neither of them are true. Row 5, again, that does satisfy our condition, we have a 0 and a 1. Row 6 also satisfies the condition. Row 7 does not satisfy the condition, since both of them are true. And row 8 does satisfy the XOR condition. Once we've completed the truth table, we're left with these two columns, S and X. Since these two connect, we now want to compare each row and write down the rows that are different. So starting off with the first row, 1 is different to 0, so we're going to write down 1. The second row is the same. The third row is different, so we're going to write down 3. The fourth row is different, so we're going to write down 4. The fifth row is different, so we're going to write down 5. The sixth row is the same, the seventh row is the same, and the eighth row is the same. So there we go. There is our answer.